This lab should be a little shorter than our previous lab, as there won't be as many passive steps while we wait for distillation to run. This will be a little more active. In this lab, we're going to be creating a medication known as aspirin. And in synthesizing that aspirin, we're going to be using some salicylic acid, some acetic anhydride, and an acidified solution using concentrated sulfuric acid. This lab is going to involve creating a crude product that is going to have some byproducts. And so the technique that we're going to be practicing in this lab is recrystallization. In recrystallization, we're going to be using something to dissolve all of our crude product and then lower our temperature such that our desired product, our pure product, will recrystallize, but everything else will remain dissolved. So that's what we're going to be doing. So to start our lab write-up, we're going to be writing an explanation of recrystallization. I'll be leaving some sources in the text box here that will go over what recrystallization is, how it works. There'll be videos and online sources together. So go through those and give me about 3 to 5 paragraphs describing what is the process of recrystallization and how does it work. In your write-up, you should be specifying how the differences in solubility are going to affect recrystallization. And these differences in solubility are going to be based on the solvent, which is the thing that is doing the dissolving, it's the liquid, the solute, which is the thing that gets dissolved, in our case this will be the aspirin and whatever byproducts, and the temperature of the solvent, how all of those impact the solubility and thus the recrystallization. So you should include references to those in your explanation. Next, you'll be writing up all of the materials that we'll be using in this lab. So go over the next 2 videos, a part 1 and a part 2, going over this entire process and write out all of the materials that are used, and, number 3, the procedure. This should be specific enough that someone could use your write-up in order to replicate this experiment. They should be able to do the exact same work that you do using your written materials. And finally, you're going to take note of any observations. In particular, I want you to note observations in the differences before and after the recrystallization. Once you've gotten all of this written up, once you've gone through the lab, you'll have a write-up and you will have some pure aspirin crystals. Show me the aspirin and turn the write-up in on Google Classroom.